Integration management in agile environment. In agile approaches, the first change is the way detailed planning happens. Project managers do not create the plans. Rather, the team creates the plan for the iteration. If you remember, in life cycles, I said agile is both iterative as well as incremental. Now, because it is iterative, it will have iterations. And the plan for the iteration will be done by the team members, not by the manager. The team also breaks down the items to be delivered as tasks and delivers them at the end of iteration. So what it is saying is that all the items that you are going to deliver in a project is basically part of a log file. That log file is a backlog, and that backlog is called as product backlog. The team will take the items from the product backlog, and team will tell what are the items they can deliver from this product backlog in an iteration. And the team will provide the planning. The team also will break down the items to individual tasks and will deliver the deliverable at the end of the iteration. The team members also determine how the components should integrate, as the team members are domain experts on integration. So the team members are the domain experts. Project manager role is more focused on collaboration and ensuring that the team can respond to changes. After all, Agile is about responding to changes. It is also called as change-driven method. Now, the collaborative approach adopted by the project manager, because the project manager is focused on collaboration, is further enhanced when the team members are generalizing specialist instead of just plain specialist. Now, what does this mean, generalizing specialist? It means an individual team member is a specialist in a particular skill, but also have other skills as well, possibly to a lesser extent. Taking an example, you have hired a tester. So the main skill of a tester is about testing. And also, the tester has other skills. Maybe the tester also knows a bit of coding or bit of development. The tester also knows, if needed, can participate in documentation writing. If needed, the tester also can create a build script for release, but they are skilled to a lesser extent. So the specialist skill is with respect to testing, whereas the generalizing skill is with respect to other areas such as coding, integration, release, documentation writing. Now this behavior is noted by having a T-shaped skill instead of an I-shaped skill. And this is shown here in this diagram. In an I-shaped skill, this is a vertical line and you have only specialization, that you are growing in one vertical line. Whereas, when you are talking of generalizing specialist, it is a T-shaped skill. In that, the specialization is vertical. You have one skill very good in that area, that particular team member. Also, there is some amount of generalization with respect to other areas. Team is also cross-functional in agile environment. Cross-functional means that the team has the skills needed to get the work done. All the skills needed to get the work done. Many people misunderstand cross-functional, thinking that people will be pulled from different functional department. No, not that is the way. What cross-functional is basically saying, the team, for example, is having a construction building. Whatever the skills that you need to build a building is available within the team. Design aspect, development aspect, bricklaying aspect, plumbing aspect, electrification aspect, all the aspects that is needed to build or complete the project, the skills needed are part of the team. That is a cross-functional team. So agile teams are cross-functional, and also the collaborative behavior of the team members will be enhanced if the team members are generalizing specialists.